Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden and Jean-Yves Lagalle, president of France's National Center of Space Studies, or CNES, signed an agreement for cooperation on the lander for NASA's future InSight mission to Mars. InSight will probe deep into the subsurface of Mars to understand the evolutionary formation of rocky planets, including Earth. A CNES instrument on board the lander is designed to measure seismic waves, which provide clues about the earliest stages of the planet's formation. During a congressional hearing at the Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex, chaired by Representative John Mica of Florida, plans were discussed for putting vacant KSC buildings and excess property to their best and most productive use. Also participating was Kennedy Center Director Bob Cabana. The center is in the midst of a post-space shuttle era transformation into a multi-user spaceport for commercial and government customers. Officials at Langley Research Center hosted Senator Mark Warner of Virginia for a look-see at Langley's efforts to reduce the time needed to develop space-age composite materials and make them available for market. The senator was briefed on a robotic processing platform called Isaac that will play a key role in development of significantly improved aerospace structures and allow the Virginia facility to contribute to an emerging regional composites manufacturing research and development hub. A free flight test of a Morpheus prototype lander took place February 10th at Kennedy Space Center. During the 74-second test, the lander rose to a height of 467 feet before finally landing on its target. Project Morpheus is testing NASA's all-hat hazard avoidance technology and an engine that uses liquid oxygen and methane or green propellants. These new capabilities could be used in future efforts.
You see?